Lena Tool. My name is Mr. Busani. The subject is basic science, and I'll be speaking on the importance of family traits. So I want us to look at the objectives of this lesson now. At the end of this lesson, you should be able to state the importance of family traits. 2. Differentiate between genotype and phenotype. 3. Define pedigree. These are the objectives of this lesson. So before I start speaking on our topic for today, which is the importance of family traits, I want to quickly remind us of some of the things I spoke about in my first lesson, titled Family Trait 1. I started with the definition for family trait, which have to do with the transmission of character or traits from parent to offspring. And traits that can be transmitted from parent to offspring include size of nose, size of eye, shape of ear, color of skin, quantity of hair, genetic diseases like sickle cell anemia, albinism, hemophilia. So these are some traits that can be transmitted from parent to offspring. These traits that can be transmitted from parent to offspring are controlled by what are known as genes. These genes are normally found on chromosomes. These were some of the things I spoke about in my first lesson. So back to our lesson for today now. Importance of family traits. Number one, intelligence. Intelligent parents usually give birth to intelligent children, although this is also influenced by environmental factors like food, exposure, etc. How can environmental factors, or how does environmental factors affect the intelligence of a child? Intelligent parents may give birth to a child, but if that child is malnourished or lack access to educational opportunities, that child will not be as bright as his or her parents. So that is one. Number two, resemblance. Family traits also helps to identify a member of a particular family. Three, reducing the occurrence of hereditary diseases. The study of family traits has helped in understanding some genetic diseases like albinism, sickle cell anemia, color blindness, hemophilia, etc. Prospective spouses are counseled to check their genetic makeup as genotype before entering into marriage to avoid transmitting genetic diseases to their offspring. Right now, I'll be throwing more light on a particular genetic disorder called sickle cell anemia. What is sickle cell anemia? Sickle cell anemia or disease is a disease that affects red blood cells, causing red blood cells to change from its normal shape to sickle shape, just like what you have in this picture now. This is the shape for normal red blood cell. This is sickle cell. So now I want you to take a closer look at these pictures here. This, starting with the first picture, this is a cross between a male and a female. The male is AA. The AA here stands for normal gene for normal blood cell. That is gene for normal RBC. YS here stands for sickle cell gene, or gene for sickle cell. So by crossing these four parents, we will end up having four children, as you can see in this picture. Two of these children, that is the first and third, are healthy because they are AA, while the second and fourth are what? Are carriers. They are healthy, but what? Carrying gene for what? For sickle cell trait. Are you with me? Carrying gene for sickle cell traits. So now, is this union advisable? The answer is yes. As you can see in this picture, there is no sickle. Now let's look at the second picture. This is a picture between a male and a female, both of which are carriers of sickle cell gene. By crossing these two, we end up having four children, as you can see in this picture. Two, three are what? Healthy. Why one is what? Is sickler. Meaning this child here is suffering from sickle cell anemia. Is that clear? Now the question now is this union advisable? The answer is no, as you can see from this picture. This union is not advisable. Now, there are two terms that are normally used in genetics. What are these two terms? Genotypes and phenotype. What is genotype? Genotype is the total genetic makeup of an organism. The total genes that are found in an organism are referred to as genotypes. While phenotype refers to all the observable characteristics of an organism, those traits that what that are physically expressed are what are referred to as phenotype or are referred to as phenotype. Number four, family genealogy. What is genealogy? Genealogy simply means what? The study of family history. As you can see in this picture, this is a picture showing family history. Now, for you to study family history very well, you have to construct what is known as family tree. What is family tree? Family tree, or what is known as pedigree, is a table or chart representing a line of ancestors, either of persons or animals. There are many symbols that are used in pedigree. This picture here is a picture showing what a pedigree. This circle here is a symbol representing female, and this box here or square is a symbol representing male. This symbol here represents affected male, and this one here represents affected female. This line here represents marriage line. So these are the children from these parents. So in this picture, we have three generations. This is the first generation, second generation, third generation. I believe you have learned something from this lesson. So I have a simple assignment for you. And the question is, state two uses of family tree. You have to send your answer and name to this number. Thanks for watching.